A 45-year-old woman presents with a tumor confined to the posterior mediastinum. This could result in compression of which of the following structures? In other words, one of these structures should be present in the posterior mediastinum so that it will be compressed by the tumor. Other structures are not present in the posterior mediastinum. So to start with, we need to define what is the posterior mediastinum. For descriptive purposes, the mediastinum is divided by the transverse thoracic plane. This is a plane that passes through the sternal angle anteriorly and posteriorly is located at the level of the intervertebral disc between T4 and T5 vertebra, transverse thoracic plane. It divides the mediastinum into a superior mediastinum and inferior mediastinum. The inferior mediastinum is further subdivided into three areas. A narrow area, which is located anteriorly, this region, which is called the anterior mediastinum, and a middle region here, which contains the heart and the beginning of the great vessels enclosed in the pericardium, and this is called the middle mediastinum. And then posteriorly located is the posterior mediastinum. So the posterior mediastinum is part of the inferior mediastinum. It is the posterior part of the inferior mediastinum, and it is in continuation with the superior mediastinum. These divisions are imaginary, and they are for descriptive purposes. In other words, there are no septa or borders between these divisions of the mediastinum. Now let's look at the structure which is mentioned here that fits into the posterior mediastinum and would likely to be compressed by a tumor confined to the posterior mediastinum. First option, trachea. Here you can see this is the trachea. The trachea is located in the superior mediastinum and it bifurcates at the level of the transverse thoracic plane, so it does not extend into the posterior mediastinum. Descending aorta. Yes, this is the descending aorta, as you can see it here. The descending aorta, the aorta starts as an ascending aorta from the middle mediastinum and then forms the arch of the aorta that is located in the superior mediastinum, and then the descending aorta will descend downwards into the posterior mediastinum and leaves the thorax behind the diaphragm at the level of T12 vertebra. So the descending thoracic aorta is likely to be compressed by a tumor confined to the posterior mediastinum. Let's look at the other options. Arch of the aorta, as I have just mentioned, the arch of the aorta is a structure that is located in the superior mediastinum and not into the posterior. Its continuation, the descending aorta, is located in the posterior mediastinum. Arch of the azygos vein, this is the arch of the azygos vein. Here's the azygos vein on the right side, behind the right side of the esophagus. Here's the esophagus. And the arch of the azygos vein passes over the root of the right lung. So it is located in the superior mediastinum and opens into the superior vena cava on the right side. So it is the arch of the azygos is located in the superior mediastinum, but the azygos vein itself is located in the inferior mediastinum. Phrenic nerve is located in the superior mediastinum and then it passes along the pericardium. So it is located in the middle mediastinum and not in the posterior mediastinum.